I haven't posted a video for a while, but we did get some new Dragon Age news, so I just wanted to talk about two things. First, we got the reveal of the next Dragon Age game's title, which is called Dragon Age Dreadwolf. It's not a title that I expected, but it's also not surprising just because I feel like the Dreadwolf has a lot to do with what's happening in Thedas and what has happened in Thedas, and a lot is leading up to his plans. His plans are going to be a big change for the world of Thedas and probably happen in the next game. I don't know if Solas's plans or the Dreadwolf's plans could be like a big chunk of the game. I think it could be like a main story or the main story, but there's going to be a lot of side quests and other main stories that we delve into. It is pretty cool though that the Dreadwolf is the title. I mean, a lot of the concept art, a lot of the teasers are to do with the Dreadwolf or Solas and the Dreadwolf. And for me, that's exciting because I love Solas and I love the Dreadwolf lore, and I really want to know more about him and more about the history and what could be currently going on between Solas and the Dreadwolf form. Like, is he going to be struggling with what he has to do, which makes him the Dreadwolf, to forward his plans? I kind of see like that concept art between Solas and then you have the Dreadwolf on the other side. Like, I'm thinking Solas might be struggling with his Dreadwolf form or what he has to partake in or what he has to do in order to make his plans move forward. I mean, the Dreadwolf name carries a lot of weight in Thedas, so it also makes sense for that to be the title. Everyone, I guess, knows who the Dreadwolf is now, but still, his plans have been kind of like there's a lot going on underground, I think, with Solas and his agents, because there's still so much of what the Qunari are doing that seems like they could really focus on that as well, story-wise. The font of the Dragon Age is kind of like crumbled, and it reminds me of like the stone pillars, or in the Fade you see like the broken up bits of statue and stone floating. It really reminds me of that. So I'm thinking that could be to do with the veil being torn down, and Solas is gonna make that happen, and what big change that is gonna do to Thedas, which maybe us as the protagonist has to fix or deal with. Maybe we have to make the decision whether we want the world to go back to the way it was, or do we want Thedas to be now the way Solas has made it with the veil being torn down. This title reveal also looks a little bit different. Like, the colors that they used are pinky, purple, blue, and it just has a different feel to it than I guess other Dragon Age, which kind of has like a medieval vibe to it, where this one feels more like sci-fi fantasy, which I think makes a lot of sense because we are focusing more on Tevinter. And if you saw in the teaser trailer, like, Tevinter has that neon sci-fi kind of vibe to it, where it's much more, where they're dealing much more with magic there. So I really like it, and it makes me excited for what cities we're going to see, and what, like, just to see something different is what I'm excited for. In the blog post, they mention who is the Dreadwolf. They say Solas, the Dreadwolf. Some say he might be an ancient elven god, but some say not. Others say a betrayer of his people or a savior who now seeks to rescue them at the cost of your world. That kind of makes me think, like, again, are we going to have a choice of Solas's world or the world it was before? Maybe that could be a choice we're going to make. His motives are inscrutable and his methods sometimes questionable, earning him a reputation as something of a trickster deity, a player of dark and dangerous games. This makes me excited because I want to see Solas like that. Like, I loved him in the Tevinter Knights novel, Dreadwolf Take You. I just love seeing that side of Solas. They also say whether you're new to Dragon Age stories or you've experienced them all, using Solas's namesake no doubt suggests a spectrum of endless possibilities on where things may go. But at the core of this, like every past game, it's you. If you're new to Dragon Age, you have no need to worry about not having met our antagonist just yet. He'll properly introduce himself when the time is right. But we did hint at his return when we announced the Dreadwolf Rises back in 2018. So they're kind of building Solas up to be, I guess, the antagonist or possible antagonist. I don't know if I would like him to be the antagonist. I want him to be more gray, but we'll see. If they do a good job with it, I'm excited for it. But they're kind of saying this game isn't just going to focus on Solas or the Dread Wolf for fans who maybe may not like him or just want a new experience at a new game where it's not focused on old characters. That's cool for me. Like, it's cool that they're saying this is not all going to be about Solas or Solas's story. This is like a typical Dragon Age game where you'll introduce fresh to new characters and a new protagonist. And Solas will return, of course, and that will excite fans like me who love him or hate him or don't really care but are just excited to learn more about him and his plans. And it's really cool to see characters from older games, no matter if it's Solas, no matter if it's like Meryl, Fenris, Isabella, Aveline, like any of these characters, Shale, I would absolutely love to see any of these characters return. And that makes it exciting as well for new, because new players who play the game, if they really fall in love with Dragon Age, which I'm assuming most of them do, because who doesn't? You go back and play the other games and then you get to know these characters and companions that you fall in love with and you're like, wait a minute, I saw them in Dragon Age Dreadwolf. And it's so cool to see that. So I hope they really do bring back at least 7 older characters or companions from the other games, excluding Solas. They also just mentioned that we're going to get more Dreadwolf news later this year, which I'm excited for. Anything that they release when they are ready, I'm so excited to see. I'd love to see more concept art. I'd love to see more in-game footage or learn more about who our companions are or about the storyline. Next, I wanted to talk a little bit about the Dragon Age Absolution teaser that we got for the new animated series coming in December. That feels so far away, but I'm looking, I mean, anything Dragon Age that they put out, like, I'm going to love it. I already know. There's nothing that I really didn't like. So I'm going to love this. It looks beautiful. The animated style looks awesome. Like the characters that we're getting. It's going to be so cool seeing Dragon Age in animated form, seeing spells, seeing fighting, seeing maybe bits and pieces that we know about Tevinter or what's currently going on in the Dragon Age world right now. If they put that in this series and it somehow connects to Dragon Age Dreadwolf, that's going to be cool. Maybe we could see these companions or characters in the next Dreadwolf game. But it looks beautiful and oh my god, I am in love with the Qunari. I just want to know more about them. I wonder if this Qunari is the one that we see in the concept art. That would be so cool. I don't mind if this is something like standalone and it's not connected to the books or it's not connected to any of the games, but I am a sucker for anything that like joins or that connects. So every, like when reading Tevinter Nights, the novel, every time like we met characters from Skyhold or anything that connected to a companion, it's like, oh my god, and it just makes me so excited. So I hope that they maybe tease something to do with the next Dreadwolf game in this. Even if they don't, and this is something that's just standalone, I will still really love it because it's Dragon Age. I am so into the Dragon Age lore. I'm interested in what these characters are going to be fighting up against. Some of these scenes look like they could take place in Nevarra. We see some glowing skeletons. What looks to be like an agent from Tevinter. I don't know. The helmet is kind of similar. Reminds me of Venatori. We also have this character that reminds me of a pride demon. I don't know if this is an elven agent of Solas. I don't know if this is someone connected to Solas or this is just a demon. They're really cool. I'm really excited for this though. And I secretly hope that this connects to Dragon Age Dreadwolf and we delve into some lore to do with Tevinter or Nevarra. Or any of these demons under the city. Maybe something to do with the old gods or fighting Solas's agents. Or maybe we're going after artifacts. I'm just excited to meet these characters and get to know them and see what kind of story they're going to give us. So hopefully this year we will hear some more Dragon Age news. Maybe towards the end of the year, I'm thinking. Whenever they're ready to release something, I'll be here to cheer them on.